In this tutorial, I will show you how to make the lacy crochet bracelet. For materials, you will need a size G crochet hook, yarn of any type. I will be using hemp cord. I've already made four bracelets. This one is made out of cotton yarn. This one is made out of hemp cord. I like the hemp cord. That's my favorite because it tends to show more detail. The bracelet is made with the broomstick stitch, and the hemp cord just seems to show more definition in the stitch. This one is also made out of hemp cord, but unfortunately, dark colors don't show up very well on my camera. There's little seed beads in there. And lastly, this one is made out of a polyester cord or nylon. I'm not quite sure, but I sure do love the colors. And I was fortunate enough to find a ribbon that matched very well. You will need 2 to 3 buttons or ribbon, and you will need a large object, something that is 5.5 millimeters in diameter. I will be using this crochet hook. It doesn't say what size it is on this crochet hook. It's very large. I think it's either a P or a Q, but rather it doesn't really matter if you have the exact same size object that I have, just something that is around 5.5 millimeters. Well, let's get started. So let's begin by attaching our yarn to our crochet hook. And we're going to chain 15. So that's 1, 2, 3. Thirteen, 14, and 15. And this is what I have. So that was round one, or row one. For row two, we are going to chain one and turn. So we're going to single crochet in each chain across. There's our first single crochet. And our second. And as you can see how defined those stitches are, which is the reason why I like to use hemp cord with this particular stitch, the broomstick stitch. Fourteen. And 15. And next, we're going to extend this last loop and we're going to place it onto the bottom of our larger crochet hook. So this is what you should have. And you're going to take your large object, in this case my larger crochet hook, and I'm going to place the loop on top of the hook. So this is what I have. Okay, so our next step, and this may feel a bit awkward at first, but after a few rows, you will get used to it. So I'm holding the crochet hook upside down in my left hand. And I have the hemp cord wrapped around my left hand in my normal position when I crochet. So now what I'm going to do is take my size G, the same one I've been using, crochet hook, and I'm going to insert it into the next stitch. In this case, the single crochet that we did on the last row. Then I'm going to wrap it around the hemp cord, as you can see, and pull it through like that. Bring up a loop and then put it onto the larger crochet hook. So now we have two loops. And once we're done, there should be 15 loops on the larger green crochet hook. So let's go ahead and do that again. So here's our V stitch, that's the next one that we're going to work. So I'm going to insert my crochet hook into it, and then I'm going to turn my hook to the left. Normally I kind of pick up my loops this way, but I'm going to pick it up this way and bring it through, and I'll show you why. And then I'm going to place it onto the larger green crochet hook. So let me show you another way to do this, and I'll show you why you don't want to do it this way. So here's our hemp cord back here, and you may be tempted to wrap your finger around it and pull it through. And if you do, then it comes out twisted, which is no problem. You just turn it around and put it on your hoop. But the other way, it doesn't come out twisted, and it just kind of speeds up the process. So let's do it again. I'm going to insert my crochet hook into the next single crochet, and I'm just going to go down and pick up a loop. And as you can see, it's not twisted, so I can just go ahead and place it onto the larger crochet hook. Let's do another one. See if I can. There, you can see it a little bit better there. It through. So let's see what we have so far. So we have 6 loops on our larger crochet hook. So go ahead and finish this row, and then we'll pick up from there. So this is what you should have at this point. There should be 15 loops on your larger crochet hook or whatever object you're using. So next, we're going to take our crochet hook, our size G crochet hook, and insert it underneath the top 5 loops on our larger object, like so. And we're going to lift them off, holding the loops with our fingers to keep them together. Then we're going to take our working yarn, yarn over, pull up a loop, yarn over, and then pull through. And what we've just done is a slip stitch on the top of the 5 loops that we pulled off of our larger object. And next, what we're going to do is 5 single crochets along the top edge of these 5 loops. So I'm going to go underneath the top of the 5 loops, yarn over, pull up a loop. Now I have 2 loops on my hook. Yarn over and then pull through 2. So now what I have is a slip stitch and a single crochet. And since what we want is a slip stitch and 5 single crochets, then I'm going to do 4 more single crochets. So that's going underneath the loops, pulling up a loop, yarn over, pull through. Okay. Three more. Underneath. Pull up a loop. Yarn over. Pull through. And two more. And one more. Okay. And this is what you should have at this point. You should have 5 single crochets and a slip stitch on the top of the 5 loops. So we have 10 loops left on our larger object, and what we're going to do is pretty much the same thing on the next 5 loops. So I'm going to scoot them up to the top of the large object. Insert my crochet hook underneath the 5 loops. And lift them off. Holding them with my fingers. I'm going to yarn over, pull up a loop. So now I have my new loop and the one from the previous 5 ring. I guess I could call it that, 5 ring. Yarn over and pull through both loops. And that is my first single crochet. And what I want is 5 single crochets across the top of these 5 loops. The only one that's different is the very first one, where you have a slip stitch and 5 single crochets. Here on this 5 loop, well, set of 5 loops, we'll have 5 single crochets, and then when we do this set of 5 loops, we'll have 5 single crochets also. So let's do the other 4, 5 single crochet, other 4 single crochets. And we just need 2 more. There, you can see it. And one more. This is what you should have at this point. You should still have 5 loops on your larger object. So go ahead and finish this 5 set. It should be exactly the same as this one. You want to lift the 5 loops off of your larger object and then do 5 single crochets across the top. And we'll continue from there. So this is what you should have at the end of row 4. And what we're going to do is increase the size of the loop on the end and place our larger object into the loop. Like so. And one thing I would like to point out is if you don't have a crochet hook like this, my large green one here, you can always find something around the house as a substitute. And actually, looking around my house, I found this Sharpie, which is actually the same diameter. It's very close in diameter as my crochet hook. So I will use it from here on out, just to show you how creative you can be in finding a substitute around the house. So this is how I have the Sharpie set up. So this is going to be actually row 3 again, because from here on out, what you will do is repeat rows 3 and 4 alternating. So you'll do row 3 here, and then you'll come back with row 4, 3 and 4, until your bracelet is as long as you want it to be. So row 3 is inserting your crochet hook under the next stitch to be worked. And then you're going to pull up a loop. And place it on your object, in this case my Sharpie. Let's do that again. I'm going to insert my crochet hook under the next stitch, pull up a loop, and place it on top of the Sharpie. So continue doing that all the way to the end, and you should have 15 loops on your object. And then you're going to do row 4. And then again, row 3, and then row 4. And when you're finished, this is what you should have. And you can sew some buttons on the end, like I did here. I have some sewn 3 buttons on the end. And then they will actually fit perfectly inside of your 3 loops on the other end. And one thing about the broomstick stitch is very stretchy. So you don't have to buy a certain size button. As you can see in my other bracelet here, this button is much larger than this one. This is the cotton bracelet that I made, and I only put on 2 buttons. Also, instead of buttons, you can use ribbon. And I'll bring that black bracelet out again, even though I know it's a little difficult to see. You can see the ribbon though. So this is the bracelet. I'm going to show you how to attach your ribbon with. There are 3 loops on each end. 1, 2, 3. So I'm going to fold the bracelet over. So I'm going to take my ribbon and thread it underneath the top loop. Actually, it's between the top and the middle loop, which would be right through here. And then through the top loop. Then take the other side and bring the ribbon through the top loop from the back side and overlap them. And then take the ribbon from the back and bring it through this side to the front. Underneath here. It's between the top and middle loops. So that now you actually have both strands of ribbon coming out between the top and the middle loops. Now it gets easy. All we have to do now is just thread both pieces of ribbon through the middle loop on both sides, going in this way, and then the bottom loop coming out this way. So I'm going to insert it, both pieces of ribbon through the middle loop. So that's on the top side, now through the bottom side. And this is what it looks like so far. And the last part is to bring the ribbon through the two bottom loops. That was the underside. And then tie a knot. And there you have it. So you can actually wear it. Let's see, how would I want to wear it with the bow at the top or the bottom? I think I prefer the bottom. I mean the top of my arm. So I can go bring the camera back. Well, that concludes this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to subscribe for future tutorials. Thanks so much for watching.